Hello guys, as I told in this video, I'm gonna show you chemical reactions with sulfur hexafluoride, cause you know, everyone only does deep voice or aluminum foil sheets with it, no chemistry, so I'm gonna do it. Sulfur hexafluoride is very chemically inert gas. It doesn't interact with anything at room temperature. So, to make it react, we'll need a high temperature. And the easiest way to get high temperature is to burn metal. Lithium's burning temperature is about 1300 degrees Celsius, and the temperature of lithium's reaction with sulfur hexafluoride is more than 2500 degrees. So, let's do this reaction. And by the way, it was suggested in comments by one of the subscribers. Before I show you the reaction, I'd like to demonstrate how lithium burns on its own. It's nice and maybe you've never seen it before. To show you the reaction of lithium and sulfur hexafluoride, I fill this little flask with the gas and put a small burning piece of lithium. But I wasn't quite satisfied with this reaction, so I decided to turn this sulfur hexafluoride jet from the gas cylinder to the boring lithium. Simply put, metal reactions are based on the fact that sulfur hexafluoride decomposes into elements at a temperature higher than 800 degrees Celsius. So the products of metal reactions are always sulfides and fluorides of metals. So if I make excess gas, you can see unreacted sulfur resulted from reaction. Sulfur hexafluoride is often used as a cover gas during magnesium smelting to prevent the molten magnesium from reacting with oxygen. But if your magnesium ignites, this cover will turn into weakness. In a science article, I read that titanium reaction is also violent, so I did it too. I also did this reaction using other alkaline earth metals. Now you are gonna see a really beautiful combustion reaction of strontium. I enjoyed it more than lithium burning. I also had some metallic samarium, and knowing how active it is, I decided to use it for reaction. For those who have no idea, samarium powder is extremely flammable. Even pretty big shavings of it will ignite from a cigarette or smoldering wood. Thanks for watching it up to the end. So the last thing I wanna show you is a really fascinating reaction with lithium and solid sulfur hexafluoride. Its melting point is minus 64 degrees Celsius, so it's not very hard to freeze it and then use. By the way, just like dry ice, sulfur hexafluoride sublimates, meaning it goes from solid to gas state without transition to liquid. In this picture that I did, you can notice orthorhombic crystal structure. So it's time for the lithium reaction. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe and comment and share, because all this helps make the channel popular, and increasing subscribers is in direct ratio to the increase of my inspiration for new exotic chemical reactions. See you next video!